Gemfields have put out their interim results for the 6 months to the end of December today. To run through the details, I've got with me now Chief Executive Ian Harebottle. Ian, good to catch up with you. Good to see you.
Excellent. Thank you. Lovely to be here.
Look, fair to say, a tough half year for you. Just run us through some of the detail. What was happening there?
Yeah, I like the word tough because I think it sums everything up, because toughness, like in sport, has both good and negative implications. So let's run through. Let's start with the good. Certainly from our point of view, operating performance, I think, is excellent. So our costs are well contained. The production outputs, or definitely the Mozambican mine, is excellent. The energy effort and learning and potential within even the emeralds is fantastic. So I think there's a lot of good within it as well. Plus the fact that Gemfields is definitely a leader in our sector. We take this seriously, and everything we do showcases that. That's the positive. In terms of the challenges, our numbers were not quite what the market was expecting. For various reasons. Number one, and especially so when you compare this past 6 months with a comparative, which was in 12 months before. The previous 6 months was probably one of our best ever. So you're comparing one of the best ever with a slightly tougher situation. But in this one as well, what happened is our first auction, we had a lower quality emerald auction that was reasonably positive. We were planning for December a higher quality emerald auction and a ruby auction, and then the Indian government decided to initiate their demonetisation program. You can't say that was totally unexpected. There was talk within the market that they wanted to improve the sector and really drive positive change. But people, it did, when it came, it was implemented very quickly. And naturally, a lot of our customers, remember our customers who buy our rough and cut and polish, were impacted on that in various ways. Not only did it mean they had to refocus their business and make sure it was sustainable long term, but a lot of them, their staff weren't on bank accounts, were maybe getting cash payments, and they all had to look after that and make sure that was a priority. And we understand that. So as a result of that, two things happened. Our ruby auction in December, we reduced the value and the volume of the total material placed on offer, because while our standard customers from Thailand and from Sri Lanka were able to attend, a number of our Indian customers weren't. And then because our emerald auctions are predominantly customers from India plus other places in the world, we agreed to postpone that, and we had that last week. And I'm pleased to say the result was actually good. But from the first half, that was taken out.
Are you fairly confident what the implications from what we've seen in India? This is just a short-term issue.
Yeah, absolutely. If you ask me how short-term, that's probably less easy to say. Talking to my customers at this recent auction and in various parts of the world, I think we're all going to be stronger for it. So I'm talking as an industry as a whole, because it's forcing positive change. It's forcing much more globalization, much more first world practices in terms of bank accounts, much easier for me. Gemfields has always prided itself in our ethics and transparency and how we promote the downstream channel. And it's much easier to actually prove that when you've got everything digitized and very much from an electronic point of view. So as I said, long-term, definitely better off. Short-term, our customers, you know, had to take a little bit of adjustment, and I'm sure it'll be fine. But exactly when we can say it's over and done depends on a few other factors. It also depends on how the retail sector continues. It's picking up, but if it picks up stronger, it's going to be much quicker.
Look, it really was a tale of two halves for Gemfields. Zambia saw a slight dip in production, but Mozambique nearly doubled output.
Well, exactly
right. Talk us through what was happening there.
Talking on pure production levels, I mean, Mozambique was just wow, especially if you think this is our new baby. We have, in the one mining license, we have 360 square kilometers. We then have another 300 square kilometers in Megaruma, and we've just recently acquired another 100 square kilometers. So it's an extensive area of absolutely phenomenal resource from a ruby perspective. But over and above that, our operating performance was great. As you say, we more than doubled our output. And especially what is really encouraging at Mozambique is the value and the quality of our production went up. Plus the fact that you think the washing plant was down for the whole of December as we upgraded to a new wash plant. So that bodes very well, both for the first 6 months, but very much for the next 6 months. Coming on to Kagem, as you say, the Kagem is the one that, on the one hand, our efficiencies were excellent and the costs were very well contained. On the other hand, the actual production numbers were down, but that's very standard for Kagem. You have to realize that Kagem, the nature of the emerald deposit, is very unpredictable. in the short term. Long term, you're very sure of its, very confident of its ability to supply very solid numbers. But short term, there is some fluctuation. I've always told the market, the only thing you can be sure of when you have had a couple of great months of production is a few months of lower production. And when you had a few lower, you're going to be followed by a few great. And I believe we're really heading into that very soon. And the fundamentals are all very strong.
Well, I think the thing to bear in mind here, on the back of your results this morning, shares were down just slightly over 6%. But people who know Gemfields, now it's important to take the longer view here. I mean, your shares have nearly more than doubled in the last 5 years.
Absolutely.
Would you agree with that?
In the last 8 years, you know, so if you take 50p, we were just recently, when I joined it was around 2p, so significantly more than doubled. So it's done extremely well, and I think you're 100% right. And even that 6%, just before I came in, I think it was even less. So it had a nice bounce back to around about 48p. So I think our shareholders are very loyal. We have a very good relationship. I've always run the business by under promise, over deliver, and very honest. I meet my shareholders on a regular basis. I much prefer to look them in the eye and tell them these are our plans. And I think they catch that. And they all share our long-term vision. So at least the vast majority of our shareholders, and they understand the incredible upside potential in the company.
Well, let's look ahead to this year. What's in store? What new projects have you got on the go?
Well, a couple of things. Number one is from a marketing perspective, because Gemfield is always focused, one, on increasing demand, and two, actually increasing supply. And from a marketing perspective, we've seen a very, very exciting increase in consumer interest and demand from the young millennials, also from your higher end brands that are recognizing the value in adding color to their creative collections. And we'll be supporting that with a number of advertising campaigns. From a mining point of view, there's a lot of opportunities. The ones that the market is fully aware of, we've been involved in Sri Lanka for a while for sapphires, Colombia for emeralds, Madagascar, we've had licenses for emeralds and sapphires, and then more recently in Ethiopia, an incredibly exciting deposit. Plus, as I was saying earlier, our neighboring areas in Mozambique, and right next to the Kajem mine, we have another emerald deposit, which Gemfields owns 100% right next to that. So with that basis, if you think of how much potential there is globally, plus from a supply or demand point of view, and from a supply point of view, look, depending who you talk to, some will call Gemfields a giant business, some will call us a small business, depending where you are. But in reality, we're a relatively small business with a lot of opportunity, and therefore it's beholden on us to focus. We really have to focus and say, where can we give maximum returns in the shortest possible time? And while all of those opportunities I mentioned are very exciting, right now it's got to be our neighboring deposits in Kajem, plus our existing license area, Mozambique, and Ethiopia is really looking very exciting. But I don't want Colombia to feel left out, because that's such a great region with such lovely stones, but it's got to fit in there and be managed somehow.
A lot of opportunity and clearly a great deal of passion on your part, I can tell.
Thank you.
Really good to see you, Ian. Thanks for coming in.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.